We've all been through so much over the past few years. And finally, we are here. Congratulations to all. Five, four, three, two, one, let's go!
What's up, everyone? It's that time of year again, when our Gallaudet University students march, move their tassel, finally toss up their graduation cap, and begin a new chapter in their life. And when you finish your degree, you're off to do something you've always wanted to do. Not only that, but despite the fact that we've been navigating the unknown and the unexpected for a few years, but you're still here, ready to decompose the old environment and reduplicate the triumphs in the new environment. The changes that you have dealt with in the last few years with grace and flexibility to meet your academic goals. This tells us all today that you can do anything you have set sight on. As you move on, your path was most assuredly different than what you had planned when you started here at Gallaudet University, but your goal was the same, to be here on this day to graduate from Gallaudet University. And congratulations, you did it. That said, don't ever forget that you have more perseverance than you ever realized. Congratulations. We can't wait to see you what you do next.
Congratulations. Congratulations to the class of 2022. You may be seated. To our graduates, families, and friends, welcome to Gallaudet's 152nd annual commencement ceremony. Oh, I forgot to put my mask down. I am honored to stand here today and to recognize our graduates. We will begin with the national anthem. This will be performed by five individuals, three who are current students: Miguel Arroyo, Rachel Volmar Qualls, and Kate Rehagen. We also have one graduating student who is Payne Naimo, as well as a Gallaudet University alum, Jessica Fallstone. We welcome our team up for the national anthem. Before we do, I do want to recognize that because of our commitment here at Gallaudet University to freedom of expression and democracy, we ask for collective respect for any decision members of our community may make to stand, sit, or kneel. Thank you. Please be seated. Next, I am delighted to welcome up our beloved Bison Song team. This year, the team members are Daniela Reyna, Shane Carrizales, and Sarah Kadar. They have been sensational all year long, performing at many different events and adapting their lyrics to each event that they performed at. I'm looking forward to see what they have striked up for tonight, or for today, this special occasion. So please welcome the Bison Song team to the stage. amazing. That was great. Nothing like the bison spirit to get us started for today's commencement. You know, I am thrilled to be here, finally face to face for this commencement ceremony. What do you think? I don't know, you're a bit quiet. Isn't it exciting to be here? I'd like to take a moment to welcome various individuals with us today. Welcome to our honored guests. Thank you all for joining us here today. We also have people seated in the VIP section who are here, as long as on stage as well. There are many different individuals who are here in this room who have helped you along the way to get to this very important moment in your life. And that is none other than our faculty and staff. So if you can stand or wave, if you're able to be recognized, our faculty and staff for Gallaudet. Staff as well. We'd like to thank our faculty and staff for all of your hard work that you really have served as the backbone that supports the community of our students. Without your support, none of this would be possible. I'd also like to recognize our international dignitaries, as well as international guests who are here to celebrate commencement with us. If you can stand or wave if you're able, so we can recognize you. Next, I would like to take this moment to talk about the fact that no university is able to thrive without having shared governance. So we'd like to recognize our shared governance groups, one being the Board of Trustees, and many members are here on stage with me. We also have our executive team members here on stage and also in the audience. We have our student body government leaders who are also here. The Graduate Student Association, the Gallaudet Staff Council, and the Faculty Senate. Our operations run smoothly here at this university because of the fact that we have shared governance, so thank you for your leadership and your support. It has made today all possible. So if you are a member of one of these six groups, can you stand or wave to be recognized? Thank you. And last, but certainly not least, welcome to the family and friends and loved ones who are here to support our graduates today. Your support and your love has helped the class of 2022 persevere. From when they first started, it was because of your love and your support, and you are a critical part of making today happen. And so with that, welcome as well. So I think it was nice to recognize the people who are in our audience, but I also think it would be great for our students who are graduating today to be able to show your support and your love and your appreciation to those who got you here, for those who are in the room here to support you. So our students, can you actually show that recognition to them now? It's also important to recognize that no one can be on a journey alone. We actually are able to move through life with the support and the collaboration that we get from people around us. And that is true for all of our students graduating here today. You know, this is a practice that we're able to continue throughout our life to remind people that we are not alone. It's the love and support from others that is what is most important. So thank you all for this collective action that we're able to get you to realizing this dream that you've had here today. So thank you all for making that happen. So now we are ready to begin. I'm sure that many of you are seated wanting to get your diploma. Well, we'll first start with the speeches, and what's important about that is that our first speaker that we have for you is the Gallaudet Alumni Association President. This is Lei Tujita Alara. Please welcome President Alara to the stage to say a few words.
Thank you, President Cordano. Honorable members of the Board of Trustees, President Cordano, faculty, staff, students, alumni, families, and distinguished guests. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone, and especially to the members of the class of 2022. I congratulate you on the behalf of Gallaudet University's Alumni Association. Congratulations. You have done it. GUAA is one of the oldest alumni associations in the United States. We were founded in the year of 1889. 133 years standing strong. Today, we represent many thousands of alumni from all over the world. Many of you will soon enter your chosen careers, your life's journey. Some of you may even continue your studies. Wherever your life journey takes you, whatever you do, and wherever you go, I know you will represent Gallaudet University and GUAA well as you continue on in your life's journey. I know you will. So we, on the behalf of GUAA, we wish you the utmost best, and we look forward to having you joining our alumni family. Will you, is the question I ask. Welcome, and again, congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you, President Alara. I now ask our Board of Trustees Chair, Dr. Glenn B. Anderson, to please come forward to share a few remarks.
To the Board of Trustees, the University Administration, the faculty, the staff, families, friends, and most of all, the class of 2022. Welcome to the 152nd Gallaudet University Commencement. Today's commencement is special because this is the first time since 2019 that we are back on campus together for our traditional in-person commencement ceremonies. To the class of 2022, congratulations to each of you. I know it feels good to finally earn your college degrees. I remember a commencement address given by one of our board members, Wilma Neuhout Druchin. When she came to Gallaudet from South Africa as a freshman, she only had a few things in her suitcase. After earning both her undergraduate and her graduate degrees from Gallaudet, she was ready to return home with a suitcase full of knowledge and tools back to South Africa. And I encourage each of you to use your suitcase full of knowledge and tools and go out in the world and make a difference for the lives of all of us, both deaf and hearing. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I offer my congratulations to the class of 2022 and wish you much happiness and success.
Thank you, Dr. Anderson. Now I would like to invite up Dr. Jeffrey Lewis, our provost, to please come forward to assist with several special recognitions. We will now announce the recipient of the Distinguished Faculty Award for 2021. This honor goes to Dr. Roberto Sanchez, Professor of History and the Director of the School of Arts and Humanities.
Dr. Sanchez, please come forward.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Sanchez.
Congratulations.
Please remain standing while we announce the recipient for the 2022 Distinguished Faculty Award.
The recipient of the Distinguished Faculty Award for 2022 goes to Dr. Brian Greenwald, Professor of History and the Director of the Drs. John S. and Betty J. Shookman Deaf Documentary Center.
Dr. Greenwald, would you please come forward?
Congratulations. Today, we also recognize four retired faculty members who are being granted Professor Emeritus status. Their biographies are in your program book. And I ask each Professor Emeritus to stand and remain standing while I call your names. First, Dr. M.J. Bienvenu. Dr. Francis Duffy, excuse me, Dr. Diane Hottendorf, Dr. Lily Ransom, and Dr. Francis Duffy. Is Dr. Duffy here? Congratulations. On behalf of the entire Gallaudet University community, I thank our professors emeriti for your many years of commitment to Gallaudet University and to our students. Thank you again. We are delighted. Absolutely delighted to recognize our three distinguished honorary degree recipients for 2022. I'll be sharing brief remarks about each individual and their accomplishments. And in your program book, there's more detailed information for you to read as well. The first person is Dorothy Chiyoko Sayoka Casterline. Class of 1958. Dorothy, otherwise known as Dot, came to Gallaudet from the territory of Hawaii. Yes, the territory, because Hawaii was not yet a state. You know, I don't know if you're old enough to even know that, that it was a territory at one point, and now is the state of Hawaii. She was an English major who completed her degree in 3 years' time. Dr. William C. Stokey hand-selected Dot to work with him on his research regarding sign language. He valued her sharp eye for detail, which made her an indispensable ally in being able to transcribe signs into print. Little did Dot know that she was taking a part in a study that would change the history of the deaf community forever. Her work, along with the work of Carl Kronberg, who is also being honored today, led to the publication in 1965 of A Dictionary of American Sign Language on Linguistic Principles. At the completion of this book, the three of them also established a research lab, the Linguistics Research Laboratory here at Gallaudet, as well as the founding of our linguistics program. As an educator, researcher, and mentor, and when I visited her, she also talked about the fact that she was an early adopter, one of the first people involved with sign language films and making sure that she was writing text for captions on the TV shows. So she was one of those first people to do that. And unfortunately, she was not able to be here with us today or her family. But we know that they are watching and joining us through the live stream. I know that this recognition is long overdue, and we would like to award her the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters. The second degree goes to Carl Gustav A. O. Kronberg, class of 1955, known as Carl. He came to Gallaudet from Sweden. He was already a linguophile, fluent in several written and signed languages. And Dr. William C. Stokey had asked Carl, when he was fresh out of college and newly appointed to the Gallaudet faculty, to conduct field research on sign language. Carl's family is also here in the crowd joining us today. Thank you for being here. Now, Zelly tells an important story, is one that I will share after my presentation to all of you, that I'm thrilled to have Zelly joining us, who is Carl's wife, in the audience. It's great to see you. We recognized Carl and Dot as co-authors of that published book that I had mentioned, The Dictionary of American Sign Language on Linguistic Principles. And was also the founder of the Linguistics Research Laboratory, as well as the Linguistics Program. Carl's work, Too Long Unrecognized, which we correct today, is one that resulted in a renaissance in the field of linguistics. Not only studying American Sign Language, but it also has become the study of different sign languages all across the world, which there are 200 or 300 sign languages still to be studied. We'd like to honor Carl by awarding him the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters as well today. Our third honorary doctorate goes to Lauren Terrell Ridloff. So So the two researchers from 1965, along when we think about Lauren, the work that they did has led to what we have now seen Lauren being able to do and the opportunities she's been afforded because of their work. Lauren is from Chicago, born deaf to a Mexican-American father and an African-American mother. She graduated from the Model Secondary School for the Deaf, and it was at MSSD that she discovered theater. She went on to CSUN, became Miss Deaf America, earned her graduate degree at Hunter College, and became a teacher of young deaf students in New York City. But the theater world beckoned time and time again. Today, Lauren plays a regular character on The Walking Dead. We'll have to watch. Maybe you've already seen it. She's also guest starred in other television shows and on film. Most recently, she was Makari, a superhero in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the film called Eternals. And Makari's superpower is being deaf and using sign language. That is a superpower that she shows in the film. Is that right? So many people here may not know that this role was originally designed for a hearing white man, but the director, Chloe Zhao, rewrote it for Lauren. And there is much more to come for Lauren. I think the future is bright for you. She has inspired us, just as she continues to inspire generations of young deaf children and students, and shown them that with signing, we thrive. Today, we honor you, Lauren, by awarding you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters. And now a round of applause for each honorary degree recipient. Dot and her family could not make it here today, but we know that they are joining us via the live stream. And I would like to ask Dr. Lewis to please come forward. And Dr. Glenn Anderson, also please come forward. Today, Gallaudet University is proud to honor Dorothy Chiyoko Sayoka Casterline by awarding her the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa.
President Cordano, I ask that you confer upon Dorothy Casterline the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Gallaudet University, I confer upon Dorothy Casterline the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. And to her family that is watching, we are thinking of you, and this will be sent to your home. A round of applause for Dorothy Casterline. Congratulations, Dot. We now will confer an honorary degree upon Carl Kronberg. He is not here with us today, but members of his family who are here, including his wife, Zelly, as well as his daughter and rest of the family members. They are here to accept this degree on his behalf. So today, Gallaudet University is proud to honor Carl Kronberg by awarding him the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters honoris causa.
President Giordano, I ask that you confer upon Carl Kronberg the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters honoris causa.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Gallaudet University, I confer upon Carl Kronberg the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations. We now confer an honorary degree upon Lauren Ridloff.
Will the Board of Trustees member Cynthia Nace Bales please come forward?
And would Lauren Ridloff also please come forward? Today, Gallaudet University is proud to honor Lauren Ridloff by awarding her the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa.
President Giordano, I request that you confer upon Lauren Ridloff the degree of Honor of Humane Letters, honoris causa.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Gallaudet University, I confer upon Lauren Ridloff the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations. Wow, another round of applause. You know, I think we can give a round of applause to Dot and Carl and the family members who are joining here with us today. Again, congratulations. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Lauren Ridloff to address the class of 2022.
Good afternoon, class of 2022. Congratulations, you've made it. Celebrate this moment in your life. This is truly a moment, hopefully a happy moment for you. This ceremony is a wonderful place to pause and to celebrate. There were many steps made to get you here, and there's far more steps that lie ahead of you. Graduating right now means that you've persevered through a lot of ordinary and extraordinary challenges. You showed strength by getting out of bed every day to continue your learning, bettering yourselves, and preparing for what the future has in store for you. You persevered even when the world came to a stop and stayed home. Schools all across the world switched to distance learning, and you all, every single one of you, kept going. I am so incredibly honored to stand here and share this moment with you. I ask you to find quiet time in the day to reflect on what it took to get you here today, to this moment. I invite all of you to think about both your disappointments as well as your triumphs. I also invite you to feel pride. You should be proud of yourselves, proud of your friends, and proud of your Gallaudet family. I too am proud. I am incredibly proud to receive an honorary degree along with Dorothy Kasterlein and Carl Cronenberg. This honor represents the many small steps that they made to create a long-lasting ripple effect. The reason I'm here is because of the work done by both Dr. Kasterlein and Dr. Cronenberg. They spent endless hours and many days putting together the Dictionary of American Sign Language on Linguistic Principles in 1965. The significance of that book is that it proved American Sign Language as a real language and that there is truly a thriving deaf culture attached to that language. 57 years later, doctors Kasterlein and Cronenberg are receiving their honorary degrees. I'm proud to be here and recognize them for their work. I'll also add that I'm a proud product of their findings. I am here as your peer. I, like you, am deaf. I, like you, went through college and faced challenges and overcame them. I, like you soon will, walked away from a very familiar environment and lifestyle into something brand new. I can remember the questions and the thoughts that ran through my head as I sat there wondering, where do I go next? Who will I be? What do I do now? And how do I succeed? And you know what? The answers to all of those questions are already inside you. All you need to do is to find your own pace in life. What does it mean, really, to find your pace in life? It means to do something at a speed that is steady and allows you to continue without becoming too tired. When you pace yourself, you're able to keep going without feeling burnt out or losing motivation. Push yourself, but take it easy. Take it easy, but you should also push yourself. Find your own pace. Your pace will not be the same as others. We all move at our own speed. Some will be moving faster than you, and others will be moving much slower. However, the most important thing is that you keep going. I'm a runner. I love running. And the reason I love running is because it's really my quiet time, and it makes my body feel really, really good. But the real reason why I love running is because running actually reminds me how to live my life. When I run, I have to pace myself. If I run too fast, too soon, I get tired really easily, or I might hurt myself. And then, because of that, I have to stop before I'm actually ready to stop. But if I run at too slow of a pace, then I lose motivation. I get bored, my body feels heavy, and then I stop. But if I pace myself and run at the right speed, then that means I can run and run and run for miles. And that makes me feel great. But that magic doesn't happen every day, because naturally, each day is different. So what do? I adapt. I change to different shoes, change different running routes. I'll also try to run at different times of the day. I plan ahead. I schedule all my runs. I make sure that I have all the running clothes that I need, as well as my running shoes and my watch anytime I travel, so that way I can run anywhere at any time. I actually watch and observe other people's runs. I read runners' stories, and I learn from them. I envision myself running in their shoes. By doing all of these aforementioned things, I can find the right pace for myself and succeed as a runner. All those skills in running actually parlay directly into my work. I'm an actress. And with that, let me tell you a little bit about what it's like to work in TV and film. Getting a role is certainly not easy. Sometimes we're chosen, and sometimes we're not. There's a great deal of waiting that happens, and it requires a lot of patience. Shooting schedules change all the time. It's very hard to make plans. So often, when my shooting schedule suddenly changes, I end up having to cancel my plans. It depends on the weather, technical difficulties, other people's schedules. There's so many factors that go into that. I have to read a number of pages, translating English into American Sign Language, memorizing my lines, advocating for myself while on the set as a deaf actress, as a person of color. Often, our shoots are 10 to 12 hours a day. And a lot of the time, we end up going into overtime. We shoot in extremely challenging climates, and we find ourselves fighting against heat, wind, bugs, stiff and really tight wardrobes that are hard to zip up and get comfortable in. Many times, when I come home from a day of work, it's extremely late, at times 4 in the morning. By the time I get home, I am filthy, sweaty, sticky, exhausted, but unable to sleep. After completing all of that hard work and pushing myself outside of my comfort zone, that's when I feel the impact of moving with intention. I've found my pace. And I also know that because of the result of hard work, the power of representation. There are changes that are happening for people who are deaf and hard of hearing. I'm supporting my community. This is what gets me out of bed each and every day. Similar to what Dorothy and Carl did for American Sign Language and deaf culture, it was accomplished by a long string of days, extremely long days. Some of those days were full of big and exciting findings, and some days it appeared nothing exciting came up. Those long days, when looked at alone, can feel like forever. But with consistency, those long days add up to a finished film. With Carl and Dot and their long days, what they added up to was a summation of language and culture being recognized, categorized, and formalized. The same holds true with my runs. Each step adds up to a finished race. And the same is true with life. Those steps that you're making, they go on to add up. So for you, my friends, I want to share with you a formula that I have. Now, I shared with you the importance of finding the right pace. Take a closer look at the word pace, P-A-C-E. Within that word, I see four important life skills, and that's my formula. The P is perseverance, A is adaptability, C is commitment, and E is empathy. Pace. Those life skills apply to all of you, regardless of your interests, passions, or dreams. Perseverance is something you already know. In fact, perseverance is the reason why you are here today, celebrating graduation. Congratulations. That's awesome. The pandemic hit, but you did not give up. You did not stop. You kept it going. You all know that some days it feels easier to keep on going than it might feel on other days. And some days you just want to stop and take a break. That's okay. Just make sure to get up again and keep going. The second part of pacing yourselves is adaptability. So remember, P was perseverance, which you succeeded in that. You adapted, and that's what the A stands for. The pandemic hit and you all adapted. Distance learning, what a challenge that was. I applaud each of you. For you to have to sit at your computer, watching all those tiny faces on the screen, navigating an online education, dealing with wearing masks and social distancing, could not have been easy. But nonetheless, you did it. You've shown your adaptability. And that is a life skill that will get you extremely far in life. Be strong and be flexible. Make changes so that you can continue doing what you want. The third part of pace is C, commitment. So we've got perseverance, adaptability, and C, commitment. Commitment is a funny thing. Many times, we're afraid to commit to something because we're afraid that means we'll be stuck or tethered to something. But in actuality, commitment means that you are free. Commitment is an important and a brave thing to do. Commitment gives purpose, a sense of direction in life. And ultimately, commitment is what propels you along your path. Commitment is also something that can be a very challenging skill to hold on to. And that's when perseverance and adaptability help you remain committed. You know what else helps you pace yourselves? Empathy. And that's what the E in PACE stands for. Empathy is when you listen and share and understand those around you. No one accomplishes things alone. Empathy helps us to connect and support as we move throughout our journey. And they too, others, will go on to support you along your journey. Empathy is what strengthens the experience of community. When you pace yourself, things get done. When you pace yourself little by little, you get closer to your destination. When you pace yourself, you can actually enjoy the journey. You are all change makers. After today, you're going to go out on your separate ways, but you'll still be connected through all of your shared experiences, beliefs, and values. Every day, you will find yourselves moving at a different speed. And that's okay. Some days, you will move faster than other days. And there will be other times that you may experience just quiet moments of rest. And those moments of rest absolutely need to happen too. Just know that your pace and that your journey is perfect for you and you alone. Graduates, congratulations on your achievement today. And tomorrow, persevere, adapt, commit, and empathize. Find your life pace and run free. All right.
Thank you, Dr. Ridloff. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the undergraduate student speaker chosen to address you today. Representing the undergraduate students is Molly Fiani. Molly, please join us on stage for your address.
I want to see your energy. I want to see your liveliness. We're graduating today. Dear graduating class of 2022, proud families, friends, and Gallaudet University community, I would like to congratulate you, the class of 2022, for your hard work and perseverance in achieving your well-earned undergraduate degree here at our academic home. And Mr. Cook, thank you for accepting my invitation from Twitter, and it is an honor to have you here. Thank you, Mr. Cook. I want to introduce myself. I am Molly Fiani, and I am from Canada. My education began as a young child at a deaf school, and I moved to a mainstream environment where I was fortunate to receive good support in and out of the classroom. However, my deaf community at home is small. Growing up, I used to feel closed off in my own little world. But deep inside, I really wanted to open the door to my world to be opened and not have limited access to communication. Not being able to fully socialize with my peers and not feeling truly included in my school and work discussions, I felt disconnected and not truly accepted as an equal. But here at Gallaudet, I found a very different community. Everyone was signing here, and I felt accepted. I felt my journey really started here at Gallaudet. I was feeling overwhelmed. I felt anxious and alone. I honestly didn't think I would actually belong here. However, Gallaudet provided many opportunities and enriching experiences for me to be able to meet role models who I look up to, meet invaluable individuals, discovering opportunities to develop career skills, and most importantly, I had a sense of belonging here. I want to thank Gallaudet from the bottom of my heart. Gallaudet is important because it is a large and interconnected world, and yet, at the same time, a small, close-knit community. As I've gotten to know my classmates, which many of you are graduating here today, what became clear to me is that each one of us had a unique story, revealing the challenges, struggles, and courage that brought us all here. And quite often, if not always, there are also shared experiences and goals that connected us and made this day possible. And I want to acknowledge and thank our families, caregivers, parents and families and friends, previous teachers that inspired and supported our dreams for us to become better. I want to thank Gallaudet alumni, former and current faculty and staff whose hard work and dedication helped create the paths that we now walk on and will blaze in the future. In the last few years, the world outside has rapidly changed, and we have faced new challenges, including leaving campus and adjusting to remote learning. While COVID pandemic had the impact of keeping us physically separated from one another and negatively affecting our sense of belonging, it provided an opportunity for technology to bring us together. Gallaudet and Apple worked together to ensure that all of the students, faculty members, and staff could learn and continue to work remotely through providing Apple MacBook laptops and iPads. I want to say that it has allowed us to continue to have a sense of community here at Gallaudet. So I want to really truly thank Mr. Tim Cook for making that possible for us here at Gallaudet and making that accessible for us to have a home away from home. I'm hoping that we're able to keep our MacBooks after graduation. Fingers crossed. My hope. But with that being said, as we move forward to the next phase of our lives, we should remember how important it is that the feeling of belonging acquired while completing our degrees should not be temporary. Our stories are not yet over. I would like to share one of my favorite quotes that I hope that you will always remember. You are braver than you believe. You are stronger than you seem. And you are smarter than you think. That's from Winnie the Pooh, and it's one of my favorite books that I loved reading growing up. As we here all have connected, I'm hoping to continue those close connections with each other. We came here to gain knowledge and skills and to discover more about ourselves and each other, and I want that to continue. Let's continue to support each other in our strengths, motivations, dreams, and let us go out and change the world and influence positive change as we step into this world. Thank you, Gallaudet, and again, congratulations to the class of 2022. Now I would have the pleasure of introducing Marley Matlin. Marley is well known to all of you as the first deaf person to receive an Oscar. She won the Oscar for Best Actress in 1987 for her performance in Children of a Lesser God. At that time, She was and still is the youngest person to ever win the Best Actress Oscar. Gallaudet awarded Marley an honorary degree the same year. And she, like you, is a proud alumnus. She also served on our board of trustees and is now an honorary trustee. Marley has devoted her career to elevating the status of deaf people in the performing arts. She is a strong advocate for inclusion. She is here today to introduce our keynote, Mr. Tim Cook. Welcome, Marley.
Wow. What a wonderful day. I think I'll be standing here now. Thank you, Molly, for that lovely introduction. It's great. It's great to be back here at Gallaudet, where I humbly accepted an honorary doctorate of humane letters way back in 1987, way back probably before any of you were born. That's okay. That was the same year when I won the Academy Award as the first deaf person ever to receive that honor, just as Molly just said. Now I'm no longer alone. And though myself and many of us in our community achieved small measures of success in representation, it wasn't until this past year when it took one company under the direction of one man to break the doors wide open, shining a spotlight on the importance of inclusion, diversity, authenticity, while completely rewriting the handbook on what success means in Hollywood. This man is Tim Cook. In our independent film, Coda, Sean Heater's script told the story of a working-class deaf family, which didn't fit into the typical Hollywood blockbuster formula. And even though our film won an unprecedented 4 awards at the Sundance Film Festival, we weren't sure where it would go after that because COVID changed the world of moviegoing everywhere. Then something magical happened. A company known for innovative products and technology that changed the world partnered with us on our film. Suddenly, there we were, streaming into the universe, part of the global brand that was Apple. And even better, right out of the gate, the entire team at Apple demonstrated a commitment to accessibility and authenticity that I had never seen in my 35-year career. First of all, our film was open captioned for all audiences. Then, there were interpreters at every venue, on virtual interviews, on stages, and at awards ceremonies. And most importantly, our community was consulted at every step of the way to make sure we were included. Ultimately, CODA won 3 Academy Awards. Best Supporting Actor, Best Adapted Screenplay, and Best Picture. Redefining success in Hollywood, both socially and commercially. You know, Tim once said, you want to be the pebble in the pond that creates a ripple for change. Well, Tim, you've certainly done that for our community, our deaf community, 1,000-fold. As someone who has demonstrated a commitment to innovation, far beyond your products, infusing humanity and integrating values into everything that you build. We are proud that you joined us today as we continue changing the hearts and minds, breaking barriers, and ultimately achieving equity. To the graduating class at Gallaudet University of 2022, I am proud to introduce to you your commencement speaker, my friend, and supporter of our community, Tim Cook.
Thank you so much. I am so honored to share this momentous occasion with all of you. Thank you to President Cordano, the Board of Trustees, the students, faculty, and staff, and all the proud families and friends in the audience for welcoming me today. I want to congratulate Dorothy, Carl, and Lauren on your honorary degrees. Only one of you played a superhero on the big screen, but all three of you have set heroic examples as trailblazers and advocates for the deaf community. And thank you, of course, to Molly for the powerful words you shared with us today. Marley, I can't thank you enough for that generous introduction. As you know, Marley is a brilliant performer, one who has spent her career breaking barriers and defying expectations. But while Marley's talent shine through on screen, she is just as impressive off screen. As a person, as a leader, and as an advocate, Marley brings the same integrity and grace to everything she does. And we at Apple, we're so lucky to collaborate with her on CODA. Finally, I want to say how grateful I am for the partnership that Apple and Gallaudet have built in recent years. As Apple works to design technology that is accessible to all, we are incredibly fortunate to have such innovative and committed partners. It's thanks in part to this community that Apple Maps now has a series of guides that help users identify deaf-owned and deaf-friendly businesses. And we look forward to building on our partnership for many more years to come. Thank you. Class of 2022, you made it to this day, to this moment, to this achievement, which was never guaranteed. Every graduating class confronts challenges, but I think it's fair to say that you face greater obstacles than most. After all, you were only in the spring semester of 2020, a time when many of you were just hitting your stride when the pandemic turned the world upside down. For some of you, that meant leaving behind a campus where you have found a deep sense of community and acceptance, perhaps for the first time in your lives. For others, it meant remaining in DC without the friends and classmates you have come to think of as family. For all of you, though, it meant navigating a strange and uncertain world. It meant overcoming a whole new set of obstacles that tried to prevent you from being here today. But those obstacles, they couldn't stop you. You are here today for a reason. You earned this. And no one can ever take that away from you. The theme you chose for today's ceremony is perseverance, which is a fitting description for the tenacity that life has demanded of you and for the grit and grace you've summoned to seize your future. Gallaudet has prepared you for a lifetime of discovery. There is so much you've learned while you were here, more perhaps than you realize. Some of it happened in libraries and lecture halls, some during dorm room discussions that stretched until dawn. And in the end, what you earned here is more than a diploma. It is more than a formal education. It is experience and insight and wisdom. The questions you're grappling with today are not so different than the questions that motivate much of the world, especially at this moment in our history. For many, the pandemic upended not just the way we live our lives, but the way we think about the lives we're living. People are increasingly asking big questions of themselves. What do I really want to do with my life? Who do I really want to be? At the heart of it, I think, is one of humanity's most essential questions. What does it take to build a life that provides meaning and fulfillment? And the thing about it is that no one can answer that question for you. And that includes me. There's no iPhone feature that can come to the rescue. AI is good, but it's not that good. Still, I have one important piece of advice I want to share. So important that it's the only piece of advice I'm going to share today. And that is this: whatever you do, lead with your values. By leading with your values, what I mean is that you should make decisions, big and small, each and every day, based on a deep understanding of who you are and what you believe. These are not static things, and you wouldn't want them to be. You will learn more and grow more with each passing year, as all of us do. But there are foundational values that are bedrock, things that are core to your personality and your character. And these are the things you should choose to live by. At Gallaudet, you have received a world-class education. I hope you've used this time to think deeply and openly about the world around you, to determine what you believe and why you believe it. What matters now is that you let those ideas guide you, that you let your values lead you. This is how you build a life of meaning and fulfillment. For me, it was a sense of meaning that drew me to Apple in the first place. As a company, our purpose has always been to create technology that enriches people's lives. And we believe we can only achieve that goal through a relentless focus on our values. That's why we work hard to make technology that is accessible to everyone. Why we fight to protect the fundamental right to privacy, and why we are constantly innovating to help protect the environment and leave the world better than we found it. My values have also helped me persevere through the tough decisions in both my professional and personal life. When people question the financial wisdom of our commitment to sustainability, I spoke my values when I made it clear that fighting climate change is and will remain one of our most important goals. And in my own life, it was my values that called me to tell the world I am gay, so that I might bring a measure of hope to people still hiding who they are from the world. Put simply, my values are the driving force behind everything I do, and they're at the heart of every decision I make. Now, I recognize that leading a company and leading a good life are not the same thing. But I know in my heart that staying true to who you are and what you believe is one of the most important choices you can make. It will help you form better relationships. It will help you find more satisfaction in your work. And with a little luck and a lot of effort, it will help you build a more meaningful life. Of course, sometimes the most meaningful life is the one that's least expected. If I've learned anything, it's that the future is unpredictable, even as we put our best efforts into shaping it. And that's okay. As Eleanor Roosevelt wrote, if life were predictable, it would cease to be life and be without flavor. And so when you imagine your future and the winding path that is laid out before you, remember that the question you should ask is not what will happen, but who will I be when it does? I hope you will be kind and compassionate. I hope you will see there is wonder in being part of something bigger than yourself, and magic to be found in the service of others. I hope you will be good stewards of the planet we inhabit and participants in the fight to make it better, more equal, more accessible, more just. I hope you will hold tightly to the community you've built here, because whatever life brings, your success will be sweetened and your setbacks softened if you can share them together. Most of all, I hope you will find happiness and joy, meaning and fulfillment, and a life that gives to you all that you ask of it. Class of 2022, this is your moment, and I, for one, can't wait to see what you do. Thank you so much, and congratulations.
Thank you so much. That was beautiful. Wow. Thank you, Mr. Cook, Marley, Lauren, Molly. Your words, your speech was so powerful, and I am grateful that you are here with us today. To the class of 2022. Isn't this a joyful moment? Finally, back in person together, we're able to be face to face after 2 long years of not having our commencement ceremonies face to face. We are here to really relish in these moments with you to celebrate a well-deserved, hard-working journey that you have been on to get you here today. I'd like to take a moment to thank and to applaud and commend all of the people who have made today's event possible. There is a lot of work that went into behind the scenes and making the preparation all come together for us to be here today. So thank you all for your hard work. And what we have seen here today is a wonderful example of collective commitment to the greater good. And that is our community, working together in collaboration with one another. The pandemic taught us a very important and powerful lesson. It taught us and also reminded us of this important lesson within our community, that collective action is critical. And working alone and being isolated throughout the pandemic didn't stop us. That when the pandemic hit, we figured out how to connect virtually in the cloud. We found ways to remain connected, and you were able to continue learning, you kept working, and you kept progressing together. And when we came back to campus, in person, it took all of us working together, wearing masks, to make sure that we had everything in place regarding our safety protocols. And through it all, this collective action is what led to us being able to protect each other with our so many safety protocols. And what's amazing is that we succeeded. Our COVID numbers remained low. So that collective action that we all took to serve our community's well-being is really the hallmark of the deaf community. This experience reminds me of when I grew up in the deaf community in Delavan, Wisconsin. It was there in Delavan that I witnessed that our deaf community teaching me about the importance of showing up and supporting others, whether it was for the annual summer gathering, the Deaf Club, or any other event. The deaf community would show up in support of one another. That collective action in supporting one another is one of the hallmarks, the importance of our community. It is the strength of our community. And when we think about this work that we do, it is important that we do it together. Our individualism, while important, must also draw from the strength of our community. We succeed individually from the collective support of our community. And this leads me to the story of the honorary doctorates that were given today. That it was really three people who had written that book back in 1965, the Dictionary on the American Sign Language Linguistic Principles. And in 1988, one person received an honorary doctorate degree. That was Dr. William Stokey. And as was mentioned to us, that Dr. Stokey had told people time and time again that it was both Dot and Carl who were equally important to doing this work, and that they couldn't have done it if it weren't for the two of them working with him. He said that repeatedly to different individuals, and yet he was the only one who was recognized for the work. And we are now repairing that history. We are recognizing three people and the importance that they played in being a part of this team and as individuals who are deaf, being recognized for their contributions today. The story and the recognition of Dot and Carl being a part of this team, working with Dr. William Stokey, who was hearing, we have now come to learn that in the past, we often would refer to hearing people, and they would often be recognized for work that was done, including our community. But now, our world has changed. The world has shifted, and the world is recognizing the talents, the skills, and the brilliance and wisdom that you all bring to the world as deaf individuals. Never forget that when you leave here today, because of your individual degree that you will be receiving, this was not done alone. This was done because of the collective action from this class and from this community and the deaf community at large that got you here today. There is strength in that collective action within our community. There is strength that is there. And when your days feel lonely, think about Gallaudet. Think about your friends and come home to homecoming events to recharge and then be able to go out again. Come back and be re-energized and then go out into the world again. We are here for you. And you have been here for one another, and let us not forget that. Of all things, we have to be here for each other, and we have done so throughout the last 2 years, throughout the pandemic, and it has been a remarkable experience, one that we will never forget in our lifetime. What you have proven to me as president of this university is that you are citizens of this world, that you are citizens of this community, and that you are not just students who are simply paying to come to college to get a degree. You are citizens who have changed Gallaudet. You have brought us to where we are today. You have helped us be able to meet where we are going in the future. And we all here at this university thank you for what you have brought to us, to our community, and showing us the power of that collective action and what we are capable of doing together. And so we are all here gathered together today to celebrate all of you. Congratulations to the class of 2022. And today, I would like to take a moment to recognize that we have lost a member of our community this year, and that was Roberto Maldonado. His brother, Octavio, is of the graduating class of 2022. Octavio, where are you? Where are you seated, Octavio? His family is also joining us today. And when we think about Roberto, we remember him as a compassionate person who really understood and followed with the values of knowing that small acts of kindness are what we should be doing every single day. His influence from what he had done on his time on Earth and his time here at Gallaudet and all those he had shown support to, he had once said that he was wanting to do good things. Do good things. That is a simple yet powerful expression of the influence that we can have and how we can live. Roberto, in his short life, did good things and impacted the lives of so many. In his home state, where he went to school. And I encourage all of you to make the world a better place in the way that Roberto did. As you receive your degree here today, that is what you will take with you. That is your responsibility to make this world a better place. And be proud of who you are. You, as deaf individuals, as a part of our signing community, be the change. Build our communities. Engage with others deeply. And take care of yourselves. And take care of others. To the class of 2022 and to all of us here in this room, go forth and do good things. Thank you. I now call forward Interim Provost Jeffrey Lewis.
President Cordano, before we begin conferring of degrees, I think we should pause and let the moment sink in. Today is the culmination of so much effort. I would like to ask everyone in the audience and on the stage to stand. Look at each other. Take a moment to take this in. Breathe in this moment. Look at each other in the eye. Mm-hmm. take a look at each other, appreciate each other, thank you. Please be seated. President Cordano, it is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. William Billy Innes, Chair of the Gallaudet Faculty, who will present the candidates for collegiate degrees.
President Cordano, upon the recommendation of the faculty, I have the honor of presenting the candidates to you, class of 2022. Will all the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, for the class of 2022, please stand and remain standing. President Cordano, these candidates have completed all the requirements for the appropriate degrees.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Gallaudet University, and consistent with the standards set by the faculty, I confer upon each of you the appropriate degree with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. You may be seated. Provost Lewis, will you please join me on stage?
President Cordano, I will now call forward the students who are graduating with an undergraduate degree conferred with university honors. They are graduating today with full university honors, which requires rigorous academic coursework and successful completion of a capstone project. Would the students graduating with full honors please come forward? I present to you now Shane Angel, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. I present Haley Burton, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Sabine Castro, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Andrew McCarowitz, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Taylor Paglieri, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Brenna Smith, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Alexis Wright, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Fatima Abdul Rahim, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Hu Huda Abumad, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Philip Adie, Bachelor of Science. Moza Al Makbali, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Glenn Allman, Bachelor of Arts. Vincent Alvarez, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Zoe Andrews, Bachelor of Arts. Cameron Baer, Bachelor of Science. Juliana Bahan, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Harmony Baniaga, magna cum laude. Abigail Baker, Bachelor of Arts. Austin Bates, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Hannah Baer, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Tamel Benton, Bachelor of Science. Navea Berner Kadish. Demi Bingington. Ashley Bohortes, Bachelor of Arts. Stephanie Boundary, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Marley Brambilia, Bachelor of Arts. Lexing Brooks, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Audrey Buck, Bachelor of Arts. Jessica Budd, Bachelor of Arts. Ali Bukhamsin, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Lexi Bullock, Bachelor of Arts. Samantha Calderon, Bachelor of Arts. Majalyn Calderwood, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Ann Lee Cardoza, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Salima Carlin, Bachelor of Arts. Alyssa Carlton, Bachelor of Arts. Aiden Carrier, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Noah Carter, Bachelor of Arts. Kaylin Cartwright, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Fiona Casey, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Sharon Castillo, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Luisa Chastel Messner, Bachelor of Arts. Rollo Chester, Bachelor of Science. Kayla Sciofilo, Bachelor of Arts. Dylan Christoffels, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Sarah Clausen, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Ikeka Clay, Bachelor of Arts. Phoenix Cook, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Juan Cornero, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Bachelor of Arts, my apologies. Brooke Courtner, Bachelor of Arts. Eliza Craddock, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Isba Cristomo, Bachelor of Science. Larry Daniel, Bachelor of Arts. Paige DeFries, Bachelor of Arts. Frank Diaz, Bachelor of Science. Brianna Dyke, Bachelor of Arts. Count your blessings. Rachel Disbro, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Fritz and Marie Davina, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Delia Dortch, Bachelor of Arts. Ariella Draman, Bachelor of Arts. Corey Duke, Bachelor of Arts. Mary Engelbrecht, Bachelor of Arts. Molly Fiani, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Ramon Flores, Bachelor of Science. Malika Freeman, Bachelor of Arts. Jason Garland, Bachelor of Arts. Jacqueline Gleischer, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Chandler Guldeman, Bachelor of Arts. Kimberly Gonzalez, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Stephanie Gonzalez Patino, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Isabella Graves, Bachelor of Arts. Sienna Gutler, Bachelor of Arts. Marcus Hankins, Bachelor of Arts. Seth Hazlett, Bachelor of Science. Elijah Henderson, Bachelor of Arts. Ayala Hooper, Bachelor of Arts. Aaron Howard, Bachelor of Arts. Lori Hauer, Bachelor of Science.
Margot Hudo, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Rhett Jala, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Emily Johnson, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations. Laima Johnson, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Krista Kaknik, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Jack Khalil, Bachelor of Arts. Krishan Keasley, Bachelor of Science. Grace Keller, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Rain Kelly, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations. George Ketchum, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Dekumo Kagamatsu, Bachelor of Arts. Tazim Khan, Bachelor of Arts. Kaylee Klecka, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Dalton Kramer, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Leba Krigsman, Bachelor of Science. Sarah Kulisin, Bachelor of Science. Hugh Lam, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Winston Lane III, Bachelor of Science. Dylan Lesty, Bachelor of Arts. Megan Lochner, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Annie Lopez, Bachelor of Arts. Jesus Lopez, Bachelor of Arts. Kayla Luttrell, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Octavio Maldonado, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Aishetu Mamodu, Bachelor of Arts. Hassan Manzoor, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations. Mia Marin, Bachelor of Science. Myra Mariscal, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Martinez, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations. Gregorio Mata, Bachelor of Arts. Ronald Mattingly, Bachelor of Arts. McKenna McHugh, Bachelor of Arts. Jade Mieha, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Tyler Mendez Guerrero, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations to the class of 2022. Those that couldn't be here with us, friends and family, thank you. Drew Miller, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. William Milios, Bachelor of Arts.
That must be his dad.
Kyle Myris, Bachelor of Arts.
Scott Mosley, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Congratulations. Ole Bogne, Moso Obe, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Raymond Mukulov, Bachelor of Science. Hiroshi Nakama, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Congratulations. Francis Naslu, Bachelor of Arts. You did it, congratulations.
Not bachelors. I used to say that.
Long Nguyen, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Thank you, Mom. I love you. Sean O'Callaghan, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Taiwo Olumoya, Bachelor of Science, congratulations. Ferenica Onogubu, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Joseph Palagano, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Chelsea Peterson, Bachelor of Arts. Jack Peterson, Bachelor of Science. Congratulations. Angel Perez, Bachelor of Arts, Magna cum laude. Congratulations. Daisy Perez, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Jeanette Phillips, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Congratulations. Maria Falum, Bachelor's of Arts. Nicole Pierce, Bachelor of Arts. Latoya Plumer, Bachelor of Arts. Is he sad that you're leaving? Oh. Abraham Polanco, Bachelor of Arts. John Potter, Bachelor of Arts. Anesti Rafti, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. It's about time. Tori Rives, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Lucy Richards, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Samantha Richards, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations. Ernesto Rodriguez, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Kayla Rubano, Bachelor of Arts. Elena Rubinstein, Bachelor of Science. Congratulations to everyone. Nayeli Salinas, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. We made it, everyone. Tashina Lynn Sanders, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. I love you, Mom. Summer Seeger, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Leora Seltzer, Bachelor of Arts. Congratulations to everyone. Dylan Cicoli, Bachelor of Science. I love you, family. We did it. Marcos Silva, Bachelor of Arts. Brittany Skevlin, Bachelor of Science. Congratulations. Courtney Skevlin, Bachelor of Science, magna cum laude. Claire Slafta, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Cheyenne Sloan, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Daniel Smith, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Kaisha Smith, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Congratulations. Dara Soak, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Amanda Sutherland, Bachelor of Arts. Wolfgang Stalley, Bachelor of Science. Congratulations. Nicole Stein, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Alyssa Stover, Bachelor of Arts. Kayla Sturdivant, Bachelor of Arts. Rashida Sweeney, Bachelor of Arts. Renz Tavlo, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Congratulations, class of 2022. Dalton Taylor, Bachelor of Science. Jacob Thornton, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Jonathan Tikhonov, Bachelor of Science. Karina Traina, Bachelor of Arts. Guy Traxler, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Wilfred Trope, Bachelor of Science. We made it all. Thank you. Cody Upchurch, Bachelor of Science. Congratulations. Upchurch, Bachelor of Arts. William Vilnicor, Bachelor of Science. Mary Von Bavel, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Congratulations. Yara Vasquez Aldama, Bachelor of Science. Nicholas Vineyard, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Alveda Vinson, Bachelor of Arts. Isabella Walker, Bachelor of Science. Michaela Walker, Bachelor of Arts. Don't give up. Make sure you overcome those obstacles. We did it all. Erin Waltner, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Breland Wells, Bachelor of Arts. Jamie Werlein, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Antoine White Giddens, Bachelor of Arts. Nicole Willard, Bachelor of Science. Tammy Wilson, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. To my family, I love you all. Tyler Wilson, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Congratulations. Andrew Wisniewski, Bachelor of Science, Summa Cum Laude. Anthony Witherspoon, Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Winnick, Bachelor of Science. Eve Wood Jacobowitz, Bachelor of Arts. Graduating class of 2022, what a beautiful experience we have had here at Gallaudet. I love you all.
President Cordano, this concludes the conferring of degrees to the class of 2022.
So congratulations to our newest Gallaudet alumni, the class of 2022. You are officially alumni. Now, there will be a reception in the multipurpose room in the JSAC building for families, graduates, and those who are actually alumni now. So feel free to make your way over to the MPR, which is in the JSAC building, to continue today's ceremony and the celebrations for today. We do have a tradition here at Gallaudet where the most senior Gallaudet faculty member leads the reception carrying the mace, and we have invited Professor Doliak to lead us in the reception.
Congratulations, class of 2022.
My apologies. It seems that I have to do a better job of explaining the details for where the MPR is located. So it is in the building that is right across the street to the right, which is called the I. King Jordan Student Academic Center, or the JSAC. So just right across the street to the right, it's actually on the second floor as you go up the stairs when you go through the doors. There's also an elevator that's there for people who are not able to use the stairs. So for our graduates, now about calling you alumni, please guide your family members over there, and we'll see you there. Now, that concludes today's commencement ceremony. Congratulations to everyone.